How quickly do COVID-19 symptoms develop and how long do they last? How long before symptoms start? The incubation period of an infection is the time between being exposed to it and developing symptoms. There are several challenges with working out the incubation period for coronavirus. It is not always possible to know when people were first infected, especially if they may have received several doses of virus. There seems to be insignificant variations in the length of time it takes people to develop symptoms. Some countries only test and confirm coronavirus in people with severe infections, and it's not known if the incubation period for the people with critical, severe, moderate, mild infection is different. It's tough that many people do not develop symptoms. They are asymptomatic, so there are no symptoms to count back from. However, one study has looked at the confirmed cases from 50 provinces, regions, and countries outside Wuhan, where it was possible to identify a single source of infection. They found that the median incubation period, half of all cases occurs before this time and half after, was 5.1 days. 97.5% of the people who develop as symptoms will have got them within 11.5 days. Which symptoms comes first? A World Health Organization report based on 56,000 confirmed cases revealed that most common as symptoms to be fever 88%, dry cough 68%, tiredness 38%, coughing up sputum 33%, shortness of breath 19%, aching muscles or joints 15%, sore throat 14%, headache 14%, blocked nose 5%, coughing up blood 1%, pink or redness of the whites on of the eyes 1%. Up to 1 in 10 people present with diarrhea or feeling sick 1 or 2 days before they develop other symptoms. Other symptoms most commonly reported in other countries include loss of sense of smell and diarrhea. There does not appear to be any particular pattern in the order of symptom development. Some people will start with a cough, others will develop fever, with cough arriving only a few days later. Among all patients, exhaustion and aching all over appears to be common early signs. How and when do symptoms progress? If you have mild disease, fever is likely to settle within a few days and you are likely to feel significantly better after a week. The minimum time at which you can leave self-isolation. You may continue coughing for a couple of weeks, while you should be very careful to maintain social distancing, as everyone should. You don't need to stay in isolation just because your cough has not completely resolved. If you are well in other respects, your likelihood of infection others at this stage is low. If you still have a fever after 7 days, you must stay in self-isolation. Continue to check the patient axis coronavirus symptoms checker regularly for warning signs to look out for. In people with more severe infections, shortness of breath is likely to become more marked 7 to 10 days after they develop symptoms. This occurs because the infection takes hold deep in your lungs, leading to inflammation, which prevents efficient transfer of oxygen from your lungs to your bloodstream. Symptoms can develop rapidly in hours and worsen in minutes. It's important to remember that even if you are ill enough to need hospital admission, most people are much more likely to recover than to die. If you develop symptoms, isolate yourself from the outside world and anyone you live with for at least 7 days. Ensure everyone, you live with isolates for 14 days or 7 days from when they develop symptoms, whichever is the longer. Look after yourself with plenty of rest, fluids and painkillers if needed. Look out for worsening symptoms above. Seek medical help as needed. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please share it with your friends. For more videos, subscribe to this channel.